I personally was fortunate to be a part of all the rovers on Mars right now, starting with Sojourner in 1996, followed by Spirit and Opportunity, and now Curiosity. An awesome program. It's great to have these JPL in-house built robotic missions with the rovers. They take a personality of their own. I mean, we name them. Folks are able to follow what they're doing in this day and age of technology. You can jump on the web and figure out what they're doing right now. So awesome. It's the next best thing is really having humans on Mars. Basically, this thing's a transformer. It starts as a pancake, opens up, and you got six wheels, you have mass, you have all kinds of protuberances coming out of it. And it's all got to work right the first time. It's got to survive a rocket launch, and it's got to get skyhooked onto the surface of Mars. You got to think of MSL as more than just a rover. What folks are seeing now, if you go out to the launch pad and within the payload fairing, it's what looks like a flying saucer. I mean, it literally looks like what a science fiction flying saucer looks like. And within that is the crew stage, the aeroshells, and the lander or the rover, and not only that, but its descent stage. And the crew stage and the descent stage are propulsive. They've got to be able to steer or stop or so forth. So they're loaded with fuel. They have miniature, or they have rocket engines on them, just like the Atlas rocket does, but on a smaller scale. So there is quite a bit of complexity when you see all that put together. It starts out as a 4,000 pound payload. And by the time we're done with it, the rover is only 900 kilograms, about 1,800 pounds. So over half of that mass is stuff that is required just to get it from the moment that Atlas releases it to landing on Mars. No, absolutely not. It's awesome. It's cool. That's what engineers love to do. They all have their unique challenges, but I think that this one is cool in the fact that it's a rover. It's big. Some people say it's the size of a Mini. No, I stood next to it. It's bigger than a Mini. It's more like the smaller version of the Hummer. I mean, the wheelbase is just, you know, wide, and this thing has a mass that's 7 foot tall. So it's big, and it's very cool. MSL, because it's large, it needs a different type of power source, and we're using a nuclear power source for this one. And when you do that, it adds a bit of complexity because of the safety issues with it. NASA really takes the initiative and almost overreacts, and we bring in the DOE and other agencies that are used to handling this type of material, and we put in a lot of safeguards to make sure that the material is first kept and safeguarded well, and that the mission is bound to be perfect in the way that it launches, so that we don't have a release or have people panicked. The way the RTG is encased, there's no harm. This thing is, it's in a safe for all intents and purposes. And we really do take that extra step in making sure that this material is safeguarded and won't harm the planet. I bet you there's going to be some knockout science, some great pictures, and a great experience.